Chapter 14 Ratanji Wadia of Nanded, Saint Mauli Sahib, Dakshina Mimamsa. In the last chapter, we described how Baba's word and grace cured many incurable diseases. Now we shall describe how Baba blessed Mr. Ratanji Wadia with an issue. The life of the saint is naturally sweet in and out. His various doings, eating, walking, and his natural sayings are also sweet. His life is bliss incarnate. Sai gave it out as a means of his devotees' remembrance to him. He gave them various stories of duty and action which ultimately led them to true religion. His object may be that people should live happily in this world, but they should be ever cautious and gain the object of their life, namely self-realization. We get human body as a result of the merits in past births, and it is worthwhile that with its aid we should attain devotion and liberation in this life. So we should never be lazy but always be on the alert to gain our end and aim of life. If you daily hear the leelas or stories of Sai, you will always see him. Day and night you will remember him in your mind. When you assimilate Sai in this way, your mind will lose its fickleness, and if you go on in this manner, it will finally be merged in pure consciousness. Ratanji of Nanded. Now let us come to the main story of this chapter. In Nanded, in the Nizam state, there lived a Parsi mill contractor and trader by name Ratanji Shapurji Wadia. He had amassed a large amount of money and had acquired fields and lands. He had got cattle, horses and conveyances and was very prosperous. To all outward appearances, he looked very happy and contented, but inwardly and really he was not so. Providential dispensation is such that no one in this world is completely happy and rich. Ratanji was no exception to this. He was liberal and charitable, gave food and clothing to the poor, and helped in various ways. The people took him to be a good and happy man, but Ratanji thought himself miserable, as he had no issue, male or female, for a long time. As Kirtan, singing glories of the Lord without love or devotion, music of singing without rhythmical accompaniments, Brahmin without the sacred thread, proficiency in all arts without common sense, pilgrimage without repentance, and ornamentation without a necklace are ugly and useless. So is the house of a man or a householder without a male issue. Ratanji always brooded on this matter and said in his mind, "Would God be ever pleased to grant me a son?" He thus looked more morose, had no relish for his food. Day and night he was enveloped with anxiety whether he would ever be blessed with a son. He had a great regard for Daskanu Maharaj. He saw him and opened his heart before him. Daskanu advised him to go to Shirdi, take Baba's darshan, fall at his feet and seek his blessings and pray for the issue. Ratanji liked the idea and decided to go to Shirdi. After some days he went to Shirdi, took Baba's darshan and fell at his feet. Then opening a basket, he took out a beautiful garland of flowers and placed it around Baba's neck and offered him a basket of fruits with great respect. Then he sat near Baba and prayed to him, saying, "Many persons who find themselves in difficult situations come to you and you relieve them immediately. Hearing this, I have sought anxiously your feet. Please therefore do not disappoint me." Sai Baba then asked him for dakshina of rupees 5, which Ratanji intended to give, but added, "And he has already received rupees 3140 from him, and that he should pay the balance only." Hearing this, Ratanji was rather puzzled. He could not make out what Baba meant. That was the first time he thought that he went to Shirdi, and how was that? It Baba said that he had formerly got rupees 3140 from him. He could not solve the riddle, but he sat at Baba's feet and gave the balance of the darshana asked for, explained to Baba fully as to why he came and sought his help, and prayed that Baba should bless him with a son. Baba was moved and told him not to be worried, and that the time that his bad days had ended. He then gave him udhi, placed his hand on his head and blessed him, saying that Allah would satisfy his heart's desire. Then after taking Baba's leave, Ratanji returned to Nanded and told Daskanu everything that took place at Shirdi. He said that everything went on well there, but He got Baba's darshan and blessing with prasad, but there was one thing which he could not understand. Baba said to him that he had got ₹314 before. Please explain as to what Baba meant by this remark. He said to Dasganu, I never went to Shirdi before, and how could I give him the sum to which Baba referred? To Dasganu also it was a puzzle, and he pondered much over it for a long time. Sometime afterwards it struck him that Ratunji had received some days ago a Mohammedan saint by name Mauli Sahib in his house and had spent some money for his reception. This Mauli Sahib was Kuli saint, well known to the people of Nanded. When Ratanji decided to go to Shirdi, this Mauli Sahib accidentally came to Ratanji's house. Ratanji knew him and loved him, so he gave a small party in his honor. Dasganu got from Ratanji the yadi or memo of expenses of this reception, and everybody was wonderstruck to see that the expenses amounted exactly to ₹3.14, nothing more, nothing less. They all came to know that Baba was omniscient, that thought he lived in Shirdi. He knew what happened outside, far away from Shirdi. In fact, he knew the past, present, future, and could identify himself heart and soul with anybody. In this particular instance, how could he know the reception given to Mauli Sahib and the amount spent before, unless he could identify himself with him and he be one with him? Ratanji was satisfied with this explanation, and his faith in Baba was confirmed and increased. In due time afterwards, he was blessed with a son, and his joy knew no bounds. It is said that he had in all a dozen, 12 issues, out of which only 4 survived. In a footnote towards the end of this chapter, it is stated that Baba told Rao Bahadur Hari Vinayak Sati after the death of his first wife to remarry, and that he would get a son. R.B. Sati married the second time. The first 2 issues by this wife were daughters, and he therefore felt very disappointed. But the third issue was a son. Baba's word did not turn out true, but he was satisfied. Dakshina Mimamsa. Now we shall close this chapter with a few remarks about Dakshina. It is a well-known fact that Baba always asked for Dakshina from people who went to see him. Somebody may question, if Baba was a fakir and perfectly non-attached, why he should ask for Dakshina and care for money? We shall consider this question broadly now. First, for a long time Baba did not accept anything. He stored burnt matches and filled his pocket with them. He never asked anything from anybody, whether be a devotee or otherwise. If anybody placed before him a piece or two, he purchased oil or tobacco. He was fond of tobacco, for he always smoked a bidi or chillum, an earthen pipe. Then some persons thought that they could not see the saints empty-handed, and they therefore placed some copper coins before Baba. If a piece was placed before him, he used to pocket it. If it was a 2-paise coin, it was returned immediately. Then after Baba's fame had spread far and wide, people began to flock in numbers, and Baba began to ask Dakshina from them. It is said in the Shruti Veda that the puja of the gods is not complete unless a golden coin was offered. If a coin was necessary in the puja of the gods, why should it be not so in the puja of the saints also? Ultimately, the Shastras laid it down that when one goes to see God, saint or guru, he should not go empty-handed. He should offer something, preferably coin or money. In this connection, we may notice that the precepts recommended by the Upanishads, the Brihadaranyak Upanishad says that the Lord Prajapati advised his gods, men and demons by one letter, Dha. The gods understood by this letter that they should practice Dhamma, that is self-control. The men thought or understood that they should practice Dhana, that is charity. The demons understood that they should practice Daya, that is compassion. To men, charity or giving was recommended. The teacher in the Tatriya Upanishad exhorts his pupil to practice charity and other virtues. Regarding charity, he says, give with faith, give with magnanimity, that is liberally, give with modesty. with awe and with sympathy in order to teach the devotees the lesson of charity and to remove their attachment to money and thus to purify their minds, Baba extracted Dakshina from them. But there was this peculiarity, as Baba said, that he had to give back 100 times more of what he received. There are many instances in which this has happened. To quote one instance, Mr. Ganpat Rao Bodas, the famous actor, says in his Marathi autobiography that on Baba's pressing him often and often for Dakshina, he emptied his money bag before him. The result of this was, as Mr. Bodas says, that in later life he never lacked money as it came to him abundantly. There were also secondary meanings of Dakshina in many cases in which Baba did not want any pecuniary amount. To quote two instances, first one, Baba asked rupees 15 as Dakshina from Professor G.G. Narke, who replied that he did not have even a pie. Then Baba said, I know you have no money, but you are reading Yoga Vashishta. Give me Dakshina from that. Giving Dakshina in this case meant deriving lessons from the book and lodging them in the heart where Baba resides. Second one, in the second case, Baba asked a certain lady, Mrs. R. A. Tharkad, to give rupees 6 as Dakshina. The lady felt pained as she had nothing to give. Then her husband explained to her that Baba wanted 6 inner enemies, lust, anger, avarice, etc., to be surrendered to him. Baba agreed with this explanation. It is to be noted that though Baba collected a lot of money by Dakshina, he would distribute the whole amount the same day and the next morning he would become a poor fakir as usual. Then Baba took his Mahasamadhi after receiving thousands and thousands of rupees as Dakshina. For about 10 years, he had only a few rupees in his possession. In short, Baba's main object in taking Dakshina from his devotees was to teach them the lessons of renunciation and purification. Postscript, Mr. B. V. Diyo of Thana, retired Mamlatar and a great devotee of Baba, has written an article on the subject Dakshina in Sri Sai Lila magazine, volume 7, page 6 to 26, in which he says, amongst other things, as follows, Baba did not ask Dakshina from all. If someone gave Dakshina without being asked, he sometimes accepted it and at other times he refused it. He asked it from certain devotees only. He never demanded from those devotees who thought in their minds that Baba should ask them for it and they should pay for it. If anybody offered it against his wish, he never touched it. And if he kept it there, he asked him to take it away. He asked for a small or big amount from devotees according to their devotion, wish and convenience. He asked it even from women and children. He never asked all the rich for it, nor from all the poor. Baba never got angry with those from whom he asked Dakshina and who did not give it. If any Dakshina was sent through some friend who forgot to hand over the same to Baba, he reminded him somehow of it and made him pay it. On some occasions, Baba used to return some sum from the amount rendered as Dakshina and asked the donor to guard it or keep it in the shrine for worship. This procedure benefited the donor or the devotee immensely. If anybody offered money more than originally intended to give, he returned the extra amount. Sometimes he asked more Dakshina from some than that they originally intended to give. And if they had no money and asked them to get or borrow from others, from some, he demanded Dakshina 3 or 4 times a day. Out of the amount collected as Dakshina, Baba spent very little for his own sake, namely for buying chilim and fuel, his dhuni or sacred fire, and all the rest he distributed as charity in varying proportions to various persons. All the paraphernalia of the Shirdi Sansthan was brought by various rich devotees at the instance and the suggestion of Radha Krishnamayi. Baba always used to get wild and scold at those who brought costly and rich articles. He said to Mr. Nana Sahib Chandokar that all his property consisted of one cupin, cord piece, one stray piece of cloth, one kafni, and a tamral tin pot, and that all the people troubled him by bringing all these unnecessary, useless, and costly articles. Women and wealth are the two main obstacles in the way of our Paramatma spiritual life, and Baba provided in Shirdi two institutions, namely Dakshina and Radha Krishnamayi. Whenever they came to him, he demanded dakshina from them and asked them to go to school, Radha Krishna Mai's house. If they stood these two tests, that is, if they showed that they were free from the attachment of a woman and wealth, their progress in spirituality was rapid and assured by Baba's grace and blessings. Mr. Dio has also quoted passages from the Gita and Upanishads and shown that charity given in a holy place and to a holy personage conduces to the donor's welfare to a great degree. What is more holy than charity and in its presiding deity, Sai Baba? Bow to Sri Sai. Peace be to all.